like to show you now how to set up an activity for check-in inside of PowerChurch. I'm going to switch over here to PowerChurch now, and to set up an activity, I go to Membership, Activities and Skills, Setup, Maintain Activity and Skill Descriptions. In here is where we're going to list each of our activities, and we're going to specify their options on how they work with the check-in module. I'm going to switch over to the nursery activity, and first I'm going to go to the Events tab. On the Events tab, there's an option that says whether I want to be able to schedule an event for this particular activity. This will allow this activity to be used in the Events module. And on the Check-in tab is where we're going to specify all the options for this activity for use with check-in. By default, an activity is going to be set as not used. We're going to be able to set up an activity so that the check-in works as part of an event, schedule in the Event module, or we can also say always available. Always available is really designed for activities like the nursery, where we want to enable them to be checked in at any time without having to first schedule an event for that particular activity. By saying always available enables several different options for this activity. The first is, do we want to require that people be checked in the activity from a manned station so that a volunteer would check in that particular child in there and that disable self-check-in? Underneath that is two options if we want to enable self-check-in. The first is we can allow check-in from web stations. Web stations are HTML-based kiosks where people can check themselves in, or to use the regular self-serve stations. That's part of check-in as well. We will allow people to check themselves in to this activity. The next question is, do we want to require a checkout of this activity? So if we say select that, we have another option that says allow express checkout. Express checkout is used to scan barcodes that print on name badges and the parent pickup receipt to enable a quick checkout method as well. So we'll go ahead and enable that. And do we want to record attendance in the attendance module as people are checking in? We can select that option as well. And for activities like the nursery and so on, we might want to prompt for notes, and the notes will print out on a separate tag that can be given for the teacher. And especially for the nursery, do we want to prompt for the number of bags that's brought with the child? And since we enabled express checkout, the question is, do we also need to scan the bag tags as part of the checkout process as well? And we also have an option of whether we want to print a name badge or not. And when we select a name badge, we also have some options down here, whether we need the class name to print on the name badge, whether we want a security code print on the name badge, and whether we want allergies to print on the name badge. So we'll enable most of those for the nursery. We'll go ahead and save that. So now let's go over and take a look at our high school group, and let's look how we would enable check-in for them as well. First, we're going to go to the Events tab and say we want to use this activity in the Events module. Then we're going to go to the Check-in tab. We'll say we'll have to schedule an event for the high school for it to be checked in. We'll allow high school events to be checked in from self-check-in as well. We're not going to require that high schoolers be checked out of that. We do want to go ahead and record their attendance. We probably don't need to prompt for notes for high school students as well. They're a little older, and they're probably not bringing diaper bags or anything with them anymore. We will print a name badge, but we won't print the class name and security code and allergies on them. As they're older students at this point, we'll assume they know what class they belong to and so forth, and we will save that. So that's the options we'll use for the high school. So let's go look to see how we would actually schedule an event for this as well. So we close this, we go to Events, we'll say Add a New Event, and I'm going to schedule my Sunday school classes. So I'm going to say my event name is Sunday school, and give it an event type if I want to. And my start time, I'm going to pick my first Sunday that I want to schedule this for on a recurring basis, which will be the 6th, and my Sunday school hours at the 10 o'clock hour, so I'll say it goes from 10 to 11. I'm going to say this is a weekly recurring activity, happens on Sundays. I'll have it end at the end of the year. Click Next. I can fill in any descriptions. We're particularly interested here. This is for Sunday school, so I'm going to unselect church-wide. I can then select my Sunday school classes. So I'll add this event to all my Sunday school classes. Click Next. I'll enable check-in for this event. If this was church-wide, I have additional options down here. Those are used for church-wide events. Click Next. If I need to reserve particular rooms, I can do that. I can set up tasks as well, and reserve equipment, and click Finish. And now that this event is now set up for check-in, and will be used by the check-in module in PowerChurch.